Hello everyone, and welcome to New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I am your host, Richard Evans, with a new topic and a brand new set. Check it out, looking like a real YouTuber now. Cool microphone, check. White shelves, check. Neon lighting, check. Vintage New Tech equipment on display, check. Random nerdy collectibles, check. Jump cuts, check. Ready to rock and roll in a brand new way. Thank you again for watching. Going to focus now on the amazing 3-play 3P2 used for instant replay. When working with instant replays, we think of a certain moments or sections of an event that are captured and then played back with varying speeds. The 3-play system does exactly that and records the same event from multiple angles. There are 4 different ways to capture these events using the 3-play, and today I will show you all of them. So, without further delay, let me show you how it's done, son. All right, so let's start off in the 3-play 3P2 interface. And just to give you a kind of lay of the land here, I have my clip list maximized here and got my playlists and tags out of the way. I don't need them for today's tutorial. I have my 4 inputs of my basketball game coming in here. And then also my A and B outputs, which are currently set to live. You'll see that I have A selected on my control panel, and then live selected as well. So on my A output, you'll see that there's a green bar underneath, and it says live just to indicate exactly what's going on here. Okay, so before we even start getting clips for our instant replays, we need to make sure that we're recording our broadcast. So first thing we'll need to do is go to the top of the control panel, hit record. That turns red along with the red light up here at the top on the interface. And now we are recording all 4 of these angles of the basketball game at the same time. Okay, so like I mentioned in my intro, there are 4 different ways to create an instant replay. The first one I want to show you is the mark in and mark out method. And we're going to accomplish that by using these 2 buttons here at the bottom of the control panel, this in button on the left and the out button on the right. So this will allow you to set when you want to start the clip beginning, and then also when you want it to end. So perfect for games like football, when they hike the ball, and that would be your endpoint because you know that's when the play starts. And when the play stops, you can hit out and have your clip ready to go. So depending on the game that you're playing, this method might be different, but I mean, there's no one wrong or right way to operate the 3-play. There's just different ways to do it. Okay, so let's go ahead and start this. I'm gonna go ahead and let's wait for this play to end. Oh, nice shot, bro. All right, so this would be a good point in this game to do that. As soon as I inbound the ball, let's go ahead and hit my in point. And when I do that, you'll notice that the in button is illuminated in blue, meaning that that clip has just started. All right, and oh, pretty good. And now if I hit out, there we go. The blue light goes off on my in, meaning that I have created that event, which is now ready to go in my clip list here. So you'll see my event ID 01. That's when I created the recording for this, the out point of it, and then also the duration of that clip is 11 seconds. So now let's go ahead and play that one back. Again, I'm currently in my A output. I can tell my director, all right, I'm going to go and play my instant replay out on A. So we'll hit clip list, and now you'll see under A that that has turned blue, meaning that I'm going to be playing back a clip from my clip list here. All right, and before I hit play on there, just notice that underneath there is a time marker here telling me exactly how long that clip is, and also the speed that I'm playing that back at. But I'm just going to hit play on here. We're not going to go through speed controls today. So, okay, let's go ahead and let's play that back. Let's find a different angle on that. I'm going to hold down angle and then use my arrow keys and navigate to a different angle here. That's a decent one. And let's go ahead and hit play, replay ready on A, and then we'll just watch that play out. And you'll see that there is a time marker here at the bottom. Let me go ahead and start that again so you can see it. So when I hit play, you'll see that there is a duration bar that will basically say, all right, well, this is where we're going, a visual representation of where we are on the timeline, along with that clock. 3, 2, 1, replay's over. Bam, you can tell your director that. They can go back to your live broadcast, and you can go back to recording some more events. Okay, so, and when I went back to A, again, the green bar is at the bottom there. All right, so the next method I want to show you is the mark in method. Now, what this will allow you to do is to
create a clip without a specific endpoint, but you could still play it back. So for example, let's go ahead and do that. I'm gonna just start it right now since the ball is going across the halfway point. All right, and then we'll just watch this game. There's a steal and a foul. Okay, cool. Let's just go ahead and play that back anyway. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go into my clip list, and something I wanted to let you know, check this out, that blue button is still illuminated, meaning that I'm still recording that particular clip. So if I go into my clip list here, I can say replay ready on A, and I'll hit play on here. And now I'm playing back that particular clip, but you'll notice that I don't have that duration bar telling me the progress that I'm going through. I don't even have an endpoint here, so because I'm still recording that event, and that blue light illuminated on in lets you know that. But this is a good way to play things back, to just grab an instant replay, and if you want to trim that particular out point on later on, you can do that as well. But an important note, because this is still lit, that means that we are still creating that event. So eventually, we will need to make sure that this has an out point so that we can proceed. So let's just go ahead and do that now. We'll set that one out. And now you'll see that the out point and duration are now filled in. All right, so now let's go back to our live and watch this game. And the next method of creating an instant replay is probably the one that I like to use the most. And that is the mark out or just one button marking for creating an instant replay. So basically what that means is I won't hit the in button, I'll only hit the out button. And within the preferences, within the three play, what it'll do is I'll have the out point set for that replay, and then the software will go back in time depending on the duration that we set to then create that particular event. So within the interface, let's go up to the top of the screen, go to options, one button marking. And you'll see I have options all the way from 3 seconds to 30 seconds here, and I'm just gonna do 7 seconds, okay? So now what this will allow me to do is whenever I hit this out button, it's gonna create an instant replay and go 7 seconds in the past and make that my event. Okay, so let's go ahead and just watch the game here, and I'll have my out button ready. Three-pointer, and it's good, perfect. Let's hit the out point on that one, bam. And now you'll see in my clip list here, event number 3, it shows the duration of that was exactly 7 seconds, which is what I set in the interface. Okay, so let's go ahead and play that back. We're gonna do a replay ready on A. So we're already there in clip list. And let's go ahead and find a different angle here, something a little bit better than that. That one, angle 4, seems to be the best one here. Let's hit play. And you'll see I have that progress bar here and the time marker, 3, 2, 1, 0, bam. All right, so pretty straightforward on that one. I think that's my favorite way of doing this, but again, no right or wrong way to create an instant replay. All right, let's go back to our live mode and show you the fourth way of creating an instant replay. And this particular method is called delayed playback. And this doesn't even create an event at all. So you won't see anything show up in the clip list here when you do this. But it's a nice way of being able to grab some action really quick. And to do that, we need to use our jog wheel here in the center of the control panel. And what we'll do is we're gonna do a quarter twist counterclockwise. And what that will do is it will delay the playback. So I mentioned earlier on the A output, how this bar here says that it's green and that it's live. All right, so what I'm gonna do now is I'm gonna do this particular function for the delayed playback, and you'll see that this live word will be replaced by delayed. So let's just wait for something to happen here. Boom, there we go. So I'm gonna go whoop and delay that playback here. And now you'll see I just did that quarter turn and it kind of paused everything, but I can start to play that from there, or I can use my jog wheel to go through. So let's grab another angle. Again, angle 4 is probably the best one. All right, and then now I can jog wheel that through, etc. All right, now if you're playing this just like that, keep in mind, this looks like I have my footage out of sync. I don't, it's just because I'm still in delayed playback mode, which you'll see right here, all right? So the best way to do that is just hit stop, go back to live mode, and now you are back into live. So four different ways to obtain some instant replays on the 3Play. Again, it's kind of up to you what you like, what is your preferred workflow. No right or wrong way to do this. Just go in there, start pressing some buttons, and have some fun.
So to recap, four different ways to capture events for instant replay. As we go along, I'll show you more about the 3Play systems in detail. If you like this video, be sure to let us know by commenting and clicking subscribe on our YouTube channel that you can find at youtube.com/newtechinc for more upcoming videos. And to find out more about the NewTek 3Play 3P2, contact your local reseller or visit our website, newtech.com, for more information about NewTek products and services. And for formal NewTek training, I highly recommend checking out NewTek University, which you can find more information about at newtech.com/newtech-u. Also, if you'd like to attend a NewTek product demonstration, sign up for one for absolutely free at newtech.com/demo. And if you're posting your work on social media, make sure you tag us in your posts using the hashtags NewTek, TriCaster, or 3Play. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you again soon for another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials.